Hello and welcome inside the WOSN studios. It's time for another edition of Mark's Madness, joined by Mark Miller. I'm Matt Finkel. Time to break down some week three football action. Lots to get to. But Mark, I want to start. What is your takeaway of the season? Let's go the whole macro right now. Let's look macro. The whole season, 3 weeks in. What's your biggest headline?
Well, I'm going to go with two. One is a good headline. One is a bad headline.
Okay.
A bad headline is I think the WBL is disappointing this year as far as their records. Only three teams out of 10 that have a winning record. Two of them undefeated still, OG and Wapak. OG just beat Salina, so Salina's got the one loss. But 14 and 16 overall, that's an under 50% winning percentage, which means they didn't do very well in the non-league game to start the season. My good headline is the Northwest Conference. Kind of the other side of the spectrum. They are 16 and 8, and that's a 67% winning percentage. Four undefeated teams. We got Jefferson, Spencerville, Grove, and Crestview undefeated. And just special note to Spencerville, they are plus 100 points. They've scored 114, they've given up 14 all this last weekend to Allen East. They had two shutouts in a row to start off with. And so they're really off to a great start. But I think the Northwest Conference as a whole is really, really competitive. You've got Bluffton just behind those four undefeated teams that I think is a really good team too.
Yeah, they've really impressed. That entire conference has really impressed early on. And we'll talk about the WBL a little more later on. We're going to break down a play actually from that big OG Salina matchup.
Okay.
But moving on for now, great weekend for the Lima area, specifically Lima Senior and Lima Central Catholic.
That's
two
right.
Big wins.
Yeah. Well, Lima Central Catholic gets the Road Warriors award for this week. They go all the way to Edgerton. They didn't waste any time. 45-0, 37-0 at half. We got the continuous clock thing rolling, but they did it with the pass. Dimitri Floyd had a great game. Caught five balls, two of them for touchdowns, long touchdowns, 163 yards. That puts them at 2-1, and now they're going up against Columbus Grove, so it'll be a very competitive game for them this weekend. Lima Senior gets into the track play, but boy, did they take care of business non-league, huh? This week it was Piqua coming in 2-0. Piqua's got a good program. They just dismantled them, again, with the continuous clock thing in the second half, 62-20 it ends. They've got over 500 yards total offense, and Janiel Lyles is a man. I mean, he
Absolutely.
Five touchdowns to over 200 yards rushing. They got their quarterback back healthy. Now they go in 3-0 into the track season. Let's hope they can keep that thing rolling.
Yeah, top of the track right now, it's Lima Senior and Finley,
That's
which
awesome.
Is exciting
yeah.
to see
yeah.
here in this area. Yeah. And how about Lima Senior against Piqua, knowing they defeated them last year and this year now, but previously they'd really struggled against that program. So it's great to see what Mike Fell has been able to accomplish with those Spartans.
That's right. The kids have a new attitude, and they've got skill. They've got talent. Now they're well-coached. Somebody asked me today, are they really that good? I said, yeah, I think they kind of are. You know, they're really that good. Now they're going to play some great
right.
teams.
They're going to be tested.
Here. Yeah, they're going to be tested. But that's a pretty good team and a lot of fun to watch.
Absolutely. And speaking of LCC, be sure to check out the warm-up. We'll preview LCC versus Columbus Grove. Check it out online at the website or also on WOSN. Mark, let's talk about the MAC for a second. Brody Hoyne still out, and Minster and Coldwater played a great game yeah. down in Minster. Coldwater came out on top. Jack Hemmelgarn doing the job along with Chris Posa, running back.
That's right. It takes two offensive guys to replace Brody. I saw the highlights, and Brody led the team out. Now, he wasn't sprinting,
yeah.
but he looked pretty good. So hopefully that rehab's going well. A kid in great shape, very athletic like him. He'll rehab injuries faster than other guys. But, you know, yeah, Hemmelgarn throws for 195 and a couple of touchdowns and Post runs for over 100 yards. So they put those two guys together. That's usually what Brody does on his own. And defensively, they've picked it up and had to take because, you know, the one place Coldwater was hurt a little bit was over the middle, and that's because they don't have Brody back there roaming center field, you know. So
yeah.
that's an adjustment, too. But Coldwater's good. They'll be tested this week. You know, St. Henry coming in 2-3-0 is going after each other. Luckily, they're at home.
That's another huge game this
yeah.
week. How about Anna, comeback victory over Fort Recovery. The Fort Recovery Indians played great on the road, and then
yeah.
Anna kind of turned it up in the second half, but that's a big win for Brian Reok's club as well.
It is, and they're expecting big things. They're starting to get on track a little bit, down 20-13 at half. They outscored them 21-0 in the second half. Looks like it was easy, but it wasn't. You know, they even got outgained total yardage-wise, so that was a tough one, but anytime you got Christian Williams in the backfield at running back, you got a chance.
He's so electric.
Yeah, he's a man, you know, and he's fun to watch too. So, yeah, they go to Parkway this week, and, you know, who knows what can happen on the road. So a MAC game's a MAC game. It'll be a tough test.
Yeah, that MAC is so competitive.
Yeah.
How about the Blanchard Valley Conference? We've got some teams that are really making some noise early, and I'm talking specifically about Arlington, Liberty Benton.
Yeah, Van Buren.
You
know, I mean,
yep.
Everybody kind of knew, and the coaches were even talking about it, watch out for Van Buren, watch out for Van Buren. They're going to get over the hump and be pretty tough. And I still refer back to that warm-up show you guys did where the coach took his guys off and they kind of bonded, and boy, it's working. They're playing well. They beat Macomb in overtime. That hasn't happened for quite a while.
It's a big win for the program. And Coach Kevin Schaap.
And Arlington's still rolling. My goodness. I mean, they're going up less than 7 points per game on defense. So their margin of victory is huge, 55-14 this weekend. And Liberty Benton strong, 48-0. I mean, they got Lipsick next. That'll be a little bit of a test. The real test comes Arlington and Van Buren. 2-3-0 is going up against the other two good teams. Something's got to give this weekend.
Should be interesting to see how that plays out. And again, that Blanchard Valley Conference is divided into two divisions, mm-hmm. the Blanchard and the Valley. So a lot of play there, and we've seen some great football in that conference so far, and more to come.
And they're doing it a little differently, because if you play across your own division, you play the inner division, it doesn't count towards your league. That's right.
So you can there will be two winners out of the Blanchard Valley Conference as a whole, one in the Blanchard.
One's going to win one division, one's going to win the other division.
Interesting.
Doesn't cross over like a lot of other teams, like the Big Ten does.
But, right.
Yeah. So BVC's good this year, too.
Oh,
good teams up there.
Absolutely. Yep. Time for a break on Mark's Madness. When we come back, we're going to break down a play from the game that you saw over the weekend here on WOSN, OG versus Salina. And it was a very big play at the start of the third quarter, so don't go anywhere. Back here on Mark's Madness, and time for Mark Miller to do what he does so well, break down one of the many exciting plays we had on the broadcast games this past week. And we're going to take one from OG at Salina, or Salina at OG, rather. And start of the third quarter, Mark, what do we see here? OG with a 12-7 lead.
Well, after the kickoff touchback, they start off on their 20, and they run a combination route. When you see it again, you'll see that the outside receiver breaks in, the inside receiver runs a flat, and then down the sideline, and the quarterback's going to throw it over the cornerback's head, right in the hole there before the safety, number 9, can get there, and that's a big gainer. That's a 33-yard play to start the second half.
So now the very next play from the 47-yard line, and check this out.
Well, this is Zach Underbring again. That other one was Zach Kuhlman. This is the Brad Recker. Now, this is just a go route. This is just where a coach says, my guy's faster than your guy. I'm going to run down the field, and we're going to throw it behind him. That's a perfect pass. Could not be any better. And that goes 47 yards in for a touchdown. Two plays, 80 yards, touchdown to start the second half, and that really helped the Titans' chances to open that thing up.
Yeah, from there they go on to take it by the final of 25-7, and now OG is one of two teams undefeated in the WBL. And with the Western Buckeye League this year, it's kind of interesting. We don't really know exactly what we have, but it certainly feels like the league is a lot tighter top to bottom, where anybody can beat anyone.
I think you're right. There's no gimmies this year, which means those teams that are vying for the championship is going to have to play every week. The game that we're looking forward to down the road, Wapak and OG, if they continue to win out, that could determine it.
Yeah, that could be the de facto title game. And we'll see how that plays out. Should be great football action throughout the rest of the Western Buckeye League Conference schedule. And you can see many of those games right here on WOSN. Time for our final break on Mark's Madness. When we come back, we're going to take a look at some of those Week 4 games we've got our eye on. Welcome back. Third and final down here on Mark's Madness with Mark Miller. I'm Matt Finkel. And Mark, we talked about it a little at the top of the show. The NWC has been one of your major headlines this year. And let's delve into that conference a little. Spencerville, so impressive early on the running the ball and defensively. And who are some of the other teams that have really impressed you so far?
Well, we mentioned Spencerville and their point differential of 100. But what is really impressive is the way they're doing it. Over 375 yards rushing per game.
Yes.
They can throw it. Mason Nurse can throw it, and they've got some guys that can catch it, but that's not their MO. That's not how they want to win the game. They want to keep their defense off the field, long drive, scores at the end of it, and they've been successful the first 3 weeks. Jefferson has been impressive. 3-0, lost a lot of guys from that championship team last year, but they go up to Bluffton. And they win a 22-19 game against a very good Bluffton team and got a fourth quarter comeback. As a coach, you're always looking for that, because that helps your guys grow up. That helps them never lose confidence when you're behind.
Face some adversity.
That's exactly right.
See what you're made of.
And they did it. And so that's a big win for them. Now these teams are going to start pounding on each other. You know, yes. Crestview hasn't played a league game yet. They're getting into the NWC now. It's going to get real interesting here in the next few weeks. But that's what it's all about when you got some good teams, and they've got four at the top right now.
Going to be fun to watch Zach Goeke and Trevor McMichael and those guys that pound the rock for Spencerville continue on into this league play. Now, at week five, I'm going to ask you to give out some midseason awards just so you can start preparing yourself. I want to know who you've got as best coach, best offensive player, best defensive player. So let's do a little thermometer test here week three. Who do you think would – who's your favorite in line for those awards, those midseason awards?
Well, my preseason award, offensive and defensive, went to Brody Horn.
Right.
Brody's hurt.
He's hurt.
You know, now for the time that he played, he was everything as advertised.
Oh, yes.
You know, he'll be just getting back when we start to, you know, talk about this stuff. So, but there's some other guys. I mean, Janiel Lyles, I mean, how do you find a running back, you know, much more productive than that guy?
He was averaging 10 yards a carry going into week three. Oh, I didn't catch his stats from week three, but I don't think it declined that much from 10 yards a carry, if it did at all.
The thing that impresses you about him is he hurts guys that try to tackle him.
Yes.
You know, he either jukes them and leaves them in the dust, or he runs right over them, you know. So he's got that ability. Of course, you mentioned Goeke from Spencerville. He does everything for him, offensive, defensive. There's a lot of good players in our area, and they're just starting to get the notoriety. You know, Preston Selesky at Crestview had a monster game last weekend against Wayne Trace. So some guys that we expected to do it and some new guys coming on the scene, we'll have to review them and pick and choose, you know.
Yeah, we got a lot of good guys to choose from.
Yes,
that's a great problem to have.
Yeah.
Great football in the area.
It is.
All right, let's turn our attention now to week four. Right. We got some great games on the broadcast schedule coming up for you. But the first one you're looking at is what we'll be featuring on the warm-up, LCC Grove.
That's right. LCC at Grove. LCC's 2-1. Grove is 3-0. Maybe a little surprise. You know, they've started the season off good. Had a tough couple of seasons, but they got them rolling up there. And there's a lot going on in this game. You know, we're at home. We're bringing LCC, former member of the NWC, back in here. And, oh, by the way, they just got our old coach. You
right.
know, he's their head coach. We love him. He used to play for us. He won a state championship here. He used to coach us. Do I cheer for him or against him? Well, this night they're cheering against him because they want the Bulldogs to beat the T-Birds, that's for sure. It'll be a lot of fun, big crowd, a lot of excitement.
Great storylines in that one.
Yeah.
We were talking about the BVC before. We've got Lipsick, Liberty Benton on the schedule this week, Friday at 11 on WOSN. That's going to
be
a good one.
Scored.
Points scored.
Yeah.
And then also in the MAC, St. Henry Coldwater, that one will be on Saturday at 9.
Yeah.
And really looking forward to that
one. 2-3-0s. And somebody joked today, actually, I was meeting with a couple of guys, one guy from Marion Local, one guy from St. Henry. So they were giving me some MAC football info. And one guy says, man, I got to get me a 50-50 ticket.
You know, that
that
night,
could
yeah.
be a $5,000
deal. There's going to be a lot of people at that game.
Yeah. Yeah, so they're probably already selling them downtown Coldwater right now.
Without a doubt. Yeah. And also in the WBL, we'll have Bath Wapak for you. That'll be following the 75-minute sports report on WTLW at 11:15. Bell Fountain Indian Lake, Saturday at 7, preceding that St. Henry Coldwater game. Well, that's going to do it for this edition of Mark's Madness. Thanks for joining us on WOSN. We'll see you next time.